From January 1, 2018 to April 11, 2023, Your Honor, we have a total of 532 incidents of killing.
Killings?
Yes.
Sa kwan lang sa Negros Oriental lang?
Negros Oriental, Your Honor.
So, you mean to say political killing ito, ha? Or lahat na ng killing yan?
All lahat na. Killings.
So, yung hindi pa nyo na-establish one by one yung mga motibo. Pwede namang ang motive is babae, ang motive is pagnanakaw. Pero gusto natin yung political killing. Out of the 500, ilan dyan ang political killing?
Political killing.
When you say political killing, related sa politics, related sa use of power ng isang politician, parang ganon na motibo.
Dapat that was reported by...
Masort out din yun yan, out of the 500. From this, alamin natin.
Yes, sir. I think that was reported by the Director CIDG, Your Honor, the political...
Sige, isort out din yun habang may time tayo. Tawagan niyo yung mga tao niya doon, mag-overtime ng trabaho. Ha? Isort out din yung 500 na yan, ilan dyan yung dito, related sa political killing?
We have the motive listed here, Your Honor.
Sige.
Personal grudge, we have 289. We have 63 atrocities. I think this is committed by the CTG. We have 34 drug-related incidents. We have 25 hatred as motive. We have 16 as land dispute. We have 14 as revenge. We have 14. After there was heated arguments or misunderstanding. Personal gain, we have 8. Love triangle, we have 7. Victim is civilian asset, we have 4. Work related, we have 4. Unpaid debt, we have 2. Jealousy, 2. Business rivalry, we have 2. Self-defense, 2. And family feud, 2, Your Honor. This was extracted from our CIRAS, Your Honor.
Kompa, you classify further. Klaruhin natin yung kung saan dyan yung related sa politics, ha?
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi pag sinabi mo personal reasons, masyadong vague yan. That could be anything else. So, klaruhin natin for the purpose of this investigation. Yes. Mahirap man din sabihin ko sa iyo na yung 500 killings na yan, they are all politically motivated.
No, sir.
You will disagree. You will protest to high heavens pag sinabi ko yan.
Yes, Your Honor.
Am I correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, klaruhin mo. Segregate nyo properly. Okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi, but still, 500 is napakaraming taong namatay yan since 2018,
Your Honor. 5 years.
2018. In yes, 5 years, mayroong 500 killings sa isang province ng Negros Oriental. Yung 500 killings na yan, so, mag-average tayo every year. Ilang years na ba? 5 years?
5 years.
So, 100 a year?
100.
100 a year ang namamatay?
Yes, Your Honor. The highest incident is in Gihulngan with 106 incidents.
Yun naman ay related naman sa insurgency yun.
Followed by Bayawan, Your Honor, with 61.
Ilan sa Bayawan?
61, Your Honor.
61.
And in Dumaguete with 49 incidents.
49, 61, 49. But still, you establish the motives properly. Para yes, masabi natin na ito'y politically motivated.
Yes, Your Honor.
Mag-overtime yung mga tao mo doon, ha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Yes, Mayor Digamo.
You were asking po, Mr. Chair, a while ago kung yung what year it started at I think the record that the current record of our PNP is on 2018. But I would like to reiterate po, last night we submitted a PowerPoint presentation where you can trace the deaths of various individuals starting as early as 2008, going or moving up to 2023. Nandun po sa PowerPoint presentation na hiningi po ni Sir Lawrence po, and we forwarded it to your office po. Thank you po.
Sige, Kumsek, pag-aralan natin mabuti yan at i-present mo sa akin yung importanteng dapat malaman ko. Yeah, para bang there seems to be a breakdown of the criminal justice system, yeah, dyan sa Negros Oriental. Isipin mo, mag-start pa lang tayo sa pulis. Ayaw na magpa-blatter yung pulis sa police station. Pagdating sa prosecution, hindi natin alam kung ilan dyan ang na-dismiss dahil under the influence of whom. Pagdating sa, hindi naman tayo nag-aakusa, no? Pero within the criminal justice system, the five pillars of the criminal justice system, starting with the police for the investigation, the justice, Department of Justice, the prosecution for the prosecution, then the court for the trial, then corrections, doon ating mga kulungan dyan, then the community. Lahat yan mayroong papel dito sa peace and order ng Negros Oriental. So kung mayroong breakdown, eh kawawa ang mga tao dyan kung when we say there is a breakdown. Ah, kaya klaruhin ninyo yung pag-identify nyo sa mga kaso.
Huh? Yes, Your Honor. But we have to report, Your Honor, that in 2018 we have 144, in 2019 we have 136, in 2020 we have 105, in 2021 we have 63, and in 2022 we have 67, Your Honor, decreasing yung number natin.
But still, decreasing man, meron pa rin, marami pa rin yan.
Yes, sir.
Considering Negros Oriental ay this medyo kwan na probinsya. Parang makita natin, ha, na parang napakagandang probinsya ito. Parang peaceful. Yes. Parang peaceful ang tingin natin dahil andyan yung Siliman University. Basta ang gandang lugar. But din again, sa likuran pala nito ay daming killings. 500. Aralan nyo. Siguro, we would like to ask DOJ to create a special panel of prosecutors na titingin dito rin sa patayan ng Negros Oriental. Kung mayroon pang representative ng DOJ dito, Kumsek, let us communicate with the DOJ.
Yes, sir.
Kasi parang ang dami nito. Baka mayroon pang mga fiscal dyan na natakot at pinag-dismiss ang kaso. Wala akong enough records. Pero ito, sa tingin ko lang, ha, kasi kung ang police na may armas ay pwedeng ganun ang actuation, how much more yung walang mga armas na hindi makalaban, mas madaling matakot yun. Sana walang breakdown as na-observe natin sa hearing na ito.